these studies look good.
What is up, guys? Today we are back with another video, and today's video is gonna be girl talk about how niggas ain't shit. So if you are interested in this video, make sure to like, comment, and subscribe, and turn on your post notifications, and make sure to stay tuned for today's video. All right, so ladies, I did write down my top five topics of how niggas ain't shit, and I'm basically gonna go off of those topics. I also wrote down some ideas from there, and then I'll go off of there on my ideas or my scenarios or situations that I kind of deal with on how I know a nigga ain't shit. So let's get into the video. My first one is if he doesn't have a car. So if a nigga don't have a car, that's like a super turn off. No, I don't always want to drive my car, or I don't always want to pick you up. No, if he don't got a car, like, that is a red flag. Sis, run.
Nothing left to say, like, period.
Okay, because 9 times out of 10, it's gonna turn into a whole nother situation. That's why someone to use your car or drop you off at work, throw him away, okay? And don't let them tell you, my car is in the shop. Motherfucking lie, okay? Or my mama using my car. He's fucking lying, okay? Or he always wants to drive your car. When you're like, oh, let's go somewhere, and he wanna drive. Nah, mm-mm. Nah, sis, throw the nigga away. He full of shit. I'm gonna let you know that now. Nigga full of motherfucking shit. So my second one is going to be, he claims him and his baby mama situation is complicated. So this is for ladies that are dealing with dudes that got baby mamas. 9 times out of 10, how things going nowadays in today's day and age, everybody got a baby with somebody, or got multiple kids with multiple females or multiple niggas, per se. So with that being said, watch out, because if he got a baby mama and the baby is most likely under 5 years old, he's still fucking with his baby mama. They situation is complicated. They don't know what they want to do. If they really want to be together or don't want to be together. Granted, some people might be over their baby daddies or their baby mamas, so everybody's situation ain't the same. But a lot of dudes who have babies with girls, they be back and forth with their baby mamas or the bitches that they fucking with, and they be confused about what they want to do, if they want to be a family, or if they fuck my family, I want to be with my bitch, okay? Number one thing with that is, if y'all been talking for some time and you know that he back and forth, like, he gotta go to his baby mama house to see his baby, but he always claiming that he's stressed out, sis, that's a big sign he full of shit, because she's probably arguing with him about you or another female that he's dealing with. Don't let it slide. Check his ass, bitch, or leave. Okay, that's a big sign. So don't let that cross over your head. Like, oh, it's nothing. He's not he dealing with the baby mama. Okay, I'm gonna let you know that now. My second one off of that is gonna be, he talks down on his baby mama a lot to you. So if he's sitting up telling you, damn, I look good. But if he's sitting up telling you that, just all type of stuff about his baby mama, that is a red flag. That is a red flag. Don't deal with him, because 9 times out of 10, if he's talking about his baby mama to you, he's doing the same thing to her, which about you. So that's a red flag. And 9 times out of 10, he's telling her a whole story that you this and that, and he using you and woo-woo this and that to get stuff up out of you, but he really want to be with her. Don't let these niggas fool you, okay? And my third one off of that is, he claims that he hates his baby mama so much. So they got them niggas like that too, that be claiming like, oh, I hate my baby mama, boo, boo, boo. Whole time, nigga really be in love with his baby mama. Okay? Run. get away as soon as possible, baby, because he's playing you. Okay, my third topic is going to be if he doesn't have a job. So that's a super huge flag, ladies. No, stop dealing with these dudes that don't have jobs and don't have no motivation to get a job or no nothing. No, throw the motherfucking nigga away. Sex, okay. You can't be the only one coming in the house and bringing in the money, like living off one income when there's two people up in the house, but he wanna still be fucking up on you or wanna be eating up all the food or using all the electricity. No, throw him away, because no. And like I said, these situations pertain to me too as well, because I've dealt with dudes like that as well. So I'm not singling myself out, but I'm just saying these are the signs that you want to look out for and dudes that you want to stay away from, because they ain't no good ass niggas. Like, niggas ain't shit. Ooh, I look good. Niggas ain't shit but hoes and tricks. Niggas ain't shit but... Okay, let's get back on topic. First one. Niggas always want to play the video game. Y'all motherfuckers always want to sit on a motherfucking video game playing fucking Fortnite, 2K, Madden, or whatever the fuck y'all play. Y'all stay want to play on the motherfucking games and run up SRP bills or whatever, wherever y'all at and whatever y'all electricity stuff is called here in Arizona is SRP. Motherfuckers be want to run up SRP and want to be using the bitch money so they can sit at my house and play my shit. Nah. Mm-mm. Throw them away. Don't let them play you, sis. Don't. Period. My next one is going to be he always going out or always hot. It's always the ones that ain't got a job that stay want to get high. Like, you can't even support your habit. You want me to support your habit, or you want somebody to support your habit, but you don't want to get a job. Like, you want me to use my money to support your habit, but that ain't my habit. Or you always want to go out and you want to get a table, or you want to get a bottle for you and your niggas, or you want to get an outfit. Them the niggas that you really want to stay away from, because no, they is full of shit and they ain't gonna never mount to shit, sis. Run, literally. Okay, now my last one with this one is gonna be he ain't even got no phone. And if he got a phone, it's only Wi-Fi capabilities, okay? Where he wants to hit you up on social media, like Messenger. If he wanna call and argue with you when you at work, or just when you out, like, I'm not finna argue with no nigga who don't even got no phone. Nigga, you was in Messenger. Like, what are we doing? Or you on Snapchat calling me? Or on fucking Instagram? Like, any social media besides having an actual cell phone, a carrier to call me and have a decent conversation. You're not even a man. Okay? So, them type of niggas, you want to run, sis. Like I said, like, these are niggas you don't want to deal with. Like, don't put yourself in that predicament. If you see it before you get in too deep with it, run. Okay? It's plenty of fish in the sea, baby. And he's not the one. Alright. So, my fourth topic is going to be no source of income. So, this goes back to the third one. No source of income. Especially if y'all in a serious relationship and y'all live together and you the only one bringing in the money, you can't really live off of one source of income in today's day and age. Like, you just your income paying all the bills, and then you also wanting to spend your money, or when y'all go out, like, what? Like, how you look going out to eat with your nigga and you paying for it? Not to say anything wrong with it, but every time you go somewhere, you handing your card as if he's paying for it. Like, that's embarrassing. Run. If he have nobody source of income, run. So with these specific topics, it's going to be he claim he got make plans. Or he say, like, oh, I gotta make a move, or he lying, he ain't got no money. You gotta make no moves. You ain't no real hustler. Like, no, I'm sorry. Like, you just broke. Get over it. Go get a job. One of those 9-to-5s that you claim that you can make what I make in a week. You can make that in a hour or two. You can't. Get a real job like everybody else and stop acting like you're a real hustler. Okay. The next one is if they stay asking to borrow money, like, oh, let me just get like $20-$30 so I can get a whatever the stuff is when they say weed. I don't know nothing about no weed, so I can't really say. Let me get this so I can woo-woo this, or oh, the new woo-woo coming out. Let me no. The fuck, go get a job. You ain't gotta worry about asking me to borrow no money. Go get your ass a motherfucking job, nigga. Okay. And then my third one for that is always busy when you hit him up. Always talking about, oh, I'm busy, oh, I'm doing this, or I'm making moves, I'm in these streets, I'm in traffic. And then when you meet up with him, nigga ain't got no money because he asking about your money. Just be lying, sis. So when you get one like that, sis, run. Niggas be straight lying. Nigga ain't got no money. Nigga ain't got shit. With a motherfucking mouth that he gonna run and keep lying and talking to you. And if you keep believing him, he gonna keep telling you the lies and he gonna keep running your pockets, using your car, arguing with you off social medias, and he ain't even got no cell phone carrier. I'm telling y'all, like, these situations you really want to run from, because these niggas real life be on some other shit. All right, so number 5, my last one, is going to be all he can offer is the D. Like I said, once again, I've been in these situations as well before. These are situations and niggas that you want to stay away from. Because if all they got to offer you is dick, you're in for a rude awakening. Okay? Some niggas like that, they like to knock you up because they know you got a lot to offer. So let me knock her up so I can make sure I got this bitch on my team. And she ain't going nowhere, okay? These is niggas you wanna stay away from. If all he got to offer is the D. You gotta pay for all the dates, cause he has no source of income. So you gotta pay for everything. That's already a red flag, okay? Second one is you gotta drive and pick him up all the time. He has no car. So you gotta pick him up, sis, okay? Third one is, you always gotta chill at, y'all always gotta chill at your spot because he ain't got no job. He ain't got no source of income. He has no car. Okay? So he has no, his own place. You gotta chill at your place. No. What my mama always taught me is study these people you sleep with before you put yourself in a predicament that you cannot get out of. As far as having a baby or catching an STD from one of these ancient ass niggas, sis, for real. Like, these are the niggas you want to stay away from, and they be the hard ones to stay away from too. I'm telling you, they be having the best D. They talk the slickest. You like, oh my god, but girl, he was who, baby? It ain't even worth it. I'm telling you. Run, sis, okay? So that concludes today's video about niggas ain't shit, ain't gonna never be shit, or never amount to shit. If you catch you one of these niggas, baby, run. It's not a game. I'm telling you, they got way more better niggas out there in this sea that is not on this list. Cause these niggas on this list ain't shit. So these are the niggas you wanna run from and get away from and stay far away from. If you enjoyed today's video, once again, make sure to like, comment, and subscribe, as well as turn on your post notifications so you know when I upload my next video. I am going to make sure to be more consistent with my videos because I kind of did fall off. Not kind of, I fell off on posting videos. I haven't posted a video since April. when I moved into my house. And if you haven't caught that video about my moving video when I moved into my house, I'm going to also link that somewhere on the screen or down below in the description box. But make sure to comment other video ideas that y'all want to see me do or talk about. I am open to any conversation with you ladies. But I'm about to get out of here because I'm about to go watch Love & Hip Hop and Are You The One. So I love y'all. Mwah, and bye.